Hey everyone, welcome back to the Paradox Machine. We are back in the sinking city, and in the last episode we found out who killed Robert Throgmorton's son Albert, and actually ended up lying to him about it, because we do believe that the guy who is the killer was not in a stable state of mind. He was suffering from some sort of hysteria, so we told a little bit of a lie. And that prompted Robert Throgmorton to give us another question to figure out exactly what happened with his expedition. And if we look at the casebook here, we have to find out what happened to the members. Are they dead or alive and all of that jazz? And that brought us to the hotel. It looks like we got some stuff that we can explore in here. So my diary, part one. I don't know what exactly sank the USS Cyclops. I only remember the screams and the metal creaking, water filling the deck, and my headache, the worst I've ever had. I found myself among the floating seaweed, drowning. A nearby piece of boat helped me survive and reach the shore of the small island. They found me on it later, starving, half mad, and babbling about ancient ruins and their Denizens. The official said none of what I thought I'd seen was real, but my memories are true. My strange powers gained after that ordeal prove it. I found something horrible on that island, something old and dark and slithering, and it still haunts me. Interesting. Okay.
Crew of the Cyclops. Semper Fortis, brothers.
Nice.
Never again, they say.
Interesting. But what is that now? Charles W. Reed, USN. Yep, I remember that. I was actually in the Navy. I know exactly what he's talking about. There was a saying that everybody in the Navy would say is USN, never again. Yep, makes perfect sense. Laudanum. Wow. Who the fuck is taking laudanum?
No matter how much of this I chug down, the visions always return.
That's probably the giving you the visions, bro. If you're hallucinating, we now know why. Windcoat, newcomer. Let's go with the windcoat. That looks stylish. What do you guys think? Yeah, we're gonna go with that. What do we got here? A crumpled letter. Mr. Reed, you were the rare example of a man who treated one of my kind humanely. And I feel I have to repay your debt to you. Take this as a friendly piece of advice. Run, save your life, and leave this Drock City to the debts. Don't dig into its secrets, for they are not worth it. There's nothing good left here. I believe you can find a way to escape. Please heed my words, Lewis Flynn. Well, thank you, Mr. Flynn. Let's check out the bathroom before we grab that letter. Is there anything in here? Wow, that's a creepy-ass creaking noise. Note from Jay Vanderberg. Mr. Reed, it seems that you have overexerted yourself while conducting the investigation for Mr. Throgmorton. Forgive me for the audacity, but I brought you to the Devil's Reef while you were unconscious. Please take more care of yourself in the future. I won't be there for you every time. Johannes. Interesting. So does that bring us full roundabout here? Some of this stuff's kind of cool looking. Nice. Woo! Yeah, we're gonna have to get that one. Plague Doctor stuff is always cool. I don't know what that is. Oh, it's a DLC. Okay. Yeah, I'm not buying that. That's creepy. Woo! Well, we got a little bit of that. Huh. Looks like he's got a little bit of spank bank material hanging on the wardrobe. Interesting, Mr. Reed. What do you get into? Alright, enough of that. Let's move on. Any of these doors I can open? Ooh, there's one here. Just steal all this dude's stuff. He has some shell casings and we just helped ourselves. Nice. Is this our room? It is.
Makes this place feel more like home. I miss Boston.
Keep it down. Mr. Archer, I've seen you dragging things into your room. Mind the floors. I'll make you pay for any scratches you leave. Your landlord. I mean, if it was a nice floor, I'd say yeah, but I mean, this place is kind of gross. What's over here? Let's try to go upstairs first. Can't go in there. Looks like we're probably locked out of all these rooms. Oh, no, we're not. Gunpowder and alcohol, because that's just what you carry. Too many coincidences. So the lighthouse is out, several ships have gotten lost at sea, and some are now decorating the city's beaches. That's one thing, but now there's an enterprising fellow at the city port hiring salvagers to recover ships. He's turning a tidy profit from selling them. Can't be a coincidence. Need to look into it. Now, if only this city wasn't so impossible to navigate. Interesting. Anything else I can grab in here? Doesn't really look like it. This place is dingy. No one could get me to stay here. Like, that's just fact. Like, I'm not, no. That's horrifying. Above me, nope. And that's it. Okay, so that's all the upstairs rooms. We found a little bit of something, so it was kind of worth coming up here, maybe. Let's head downstairs now.
Finally, you're awake. Gotta tell you though, mister, you want to stay on here, you stop making all that noise.
Who are you? What noise? Yeah,
noise. What noise are you talking about?
I expect my guests to be respectable. Moans, chanting, all that kind of thing. It stops, all right?
Yeah, I didn't do anything, okay.
Got any proof it was me? It could have been one of my neighbors. I slept like a rock. I didn't hear a thing.
That's exactly what a newcomer would say. Your neighbors are respectable people and would never do such a thing. Don't think your yellow-clad patron means you get away with everything.
You're not exactly friendly with your guests. Aren't we the ones keeping you in business?
All these newcomers after the flood, they're stark raving mad.
What do you mean?
You can't imagine the crazy notes and books I find after they move out. Only thing they're good for is lighting the kitchen stove.
Can I have a look?
I knew it. I tell you, no one sane would be interested. And you want to take a look?
Yep.
Well, fine, fine. Take what you wish.
Sounds good. Whoa. To my dear nephew, my dear Victor, how is Oakmont treating you? Should you require any support, the Blackwoods would be happy to help you. I have arranged for that. Regarding your question, I don't know where Robert went, sadly, only that he did not stay in Innsmouth. Perhaps there is hope that he didn't perish in that cursed raid? Take care of the hotel, please. Plenty of our relatives were interested in the property, but you're still my favorite nephew. I know the Devil's Reef is in good hands. Kind regards, Aunt Portia. Interesting. Oops, wrong button again. Two shell casings and some gunpowder. So now we can start making some bullets, I think, if we can get what we need to start crafting, I suppose.
I'm watching you, newcomer.
Sounds like a plan, my guy. Alright, so we got everything I think we can here. Let's take a look. Ooh, what was that, actually? To Walter. Walter, K help you if you hear you're peddling your cheap, affordable living again. I could live with you renting out beast-ridden flop houses, but you're cutting into my profit. Don't make that mistake. I know you're on the fish market, and I have dangerous people living here that I can send after you. You've been warned, Vic. Interesting. Let's take a look at our casebook, see what we got going on here. Anything in the Mind Palace? No. Letters from Oakmont. Interesting. The hotel owner allowed me to look through the weird notes he found in rooms of disappearing newcomers. Among them, I found several pages from the diary of a man describing his life in Oakmont. He suffered from visions and marked the places where they happened. He was trying to avoid them. Interesting. So that's a side case. Lost at Sea is the main case. The key to the headquarters is Hoarders. Let's run there first, I think. Robert Throgmorton gave me a key to the expedition's headquarters. It's in the northern cover side at the crossroad of Asher Road and Hubert Avenue. City Hall. Where is this place? It's where I am now. What is this, I wonder? Just like a weird looking boat thing. Just want to double check casebook. Asher Road is in the northern. It's in a northern cover side at the crossroad of Asherwood and Hubert Road. Okay, so where's cover side? There it is. So like right up here, I guess. That's where it says, right? Like here's Hubert Ave and Asher Road. That ain't it. Right there. That sounds like a plan. Let's head out. The Devil's Reef. New fast travel trap. Ooh, we got fast travel. Okay, that's cool. So is this that boat thing? It is. Can I get on the boat? Holy cow, I can drive the boat. What do you know? So these blue roads must be water. Okay, that makes a lot more sense now. Okay. Just gotta go straight from here, it looks like, until we get to Asher Road. This game is very interesting. Like, there's a lot of crazy stuff happening. These people look miserable, dear God. Lincoln and Hubert, so go in the right direction. Like, who taught these guys how to park, too? Like, what the hell? I know that you're, you know, dealing with the flood, but if the streets are dry enough to light fires up over here, you guys can park right. Jesus. How close are we? Very. Cool. Boogity. Oh, that guy's getting smart. Suits and top coats. Can't go in there. What's with these numbers? That's so strange. Hey, we found it. In the drawers back here, doesn't look like it.
guess I don't need the key.
Nope. Dangers of diving. Divers with the bends can suffer from numerous symptoms, including pain, impaired movement, nausea, vomiting, and disorientation. Acute symptoms can occur within 10 minutes of surfacing and include paralysis, numbness, blindness, deafness, dizziness, seizures, confusion, or words coming out all weird. The paralysis and numbness can involve several different parts of the body at the same time. Interesting. In other words, don't get the bends. Bends are bad. Gunpowder. Whoa, there's something downstairs. Can we get downstairs? Thought I saw something moving down there, but might have just been me being weird. Strange. Everything about this game is spooky, and it's kinda got me on edge, I guess.
Can't say I ever saw another shell like it.
Yeah, that's weird. How to protect. According to our data, the places with paranormal activity have a strong previously unidentified influence on the human mind. We have prepared a list of solutions, including meditative practices and a supply of sedatives, to prevent cases of madness among the expedition members. I highly recommend discarding all of those charms, amulets, and religious symbols, which are of no use, and applying these scientifically valid methods of protection instead. H. Dao. I heard a weird growling noise too, just down there. Is it in here? That's definitely creepy. We got here metal scraps.
These samples glitter in a weird way. I wonder where they came from.
Hell. Fisherman reports. L. Sullivan and B. Morgan, local fishermen, report numerous large bubbles and an unbearable stench rising from the bottom of the sea. Bought a sample of weird substance floating in the ocean from J. Haraway. He claims he found it among numerous dead and strangely disformed fish. The fish were taken for analysis. Several locals mentioned a rock that rose from the seabed, making the fog shine in different colors. The witnesses felt sick and dizzy for the 2 or 3 days after the incident. L.P. Stern got severe burns after chiseling off a piece of part of the rock in his basement. Samples taken for analysis. Huh. H. Dao, anthropologist. The Oakmont University Department of Anthropology welcomes the newest addition to its ranks, Professor Harriet Dao. Her brilliant discoveries about the origins of Inuit tribes have added a new page to the history book of humanity. Now Professor Dao will embark on a new expedition to hopefully shed light on the source of the flood, and in doing so, she shed light on what may yet be to come. Hmm.
Few damp papers, all that's left of the expedition.
Maybe. From the looks of it, there's not a whole lot left.
Someone smashed it beyond repair.
What is this? That is creepy. Whoa. Did I just find a magic secret portal? Partially burned cargo manifest. The following must be deliver unreadable. Grimhaven Bay no later than Friday. MKV driving suit 6. Air tanks and pumps 4. Canned foods 18 crates. Personal belongings 6 crates with unreadable. Research equipment 7 crates do not. Air pipes 24. Phone station and wires 1. Power generator 1. Responsible for. I'm assuming that says delivery, just because I can. Shell casing, 12 springs, gunpowder. What is that noise?
This helmet's beyond repair.
Probably. Oh my god, what? Who the hell are you? I feel like I'm missing something. Interesting.
Burn it all. Make sure you get the adverts.
Out.
Yep.
We don't have time to pick it. Stand back.
Drop the papers. Smash the rest.
I fatah. Mea fei regach.
Burn it all. Make sure you get the adverts.
Several men broke into the expedition headquarters. What they didn't smash, they burned. The archives, even the newspapers.
Interesting. Can I loot this guy? Like, can I get my bullets back, bro? Like, that was inappropriate. Like, why did you do that? So apparently I don't need to find anything special to craft. I just learned that. That's neat. Neat. All right, let's move forward. And we'll head up here and we'll do our mind palace thing up in the office right here. Okay, cargo manifest and burn documents. The expedition archive is lost, but I still have clues to follow up on. They left the city on a freighter from Grimhaven Bay. There might be recent postings or ads about the freighter in the Oakmont Chronicle. Interesting. Burn newspapers, expedition archive is lost, but they still have clues to follow up on. Okay, cool. We already did that. Pillaged headquarters, several men with the Innsmouth syndrome broke into the expedition headquarters and destroyed everything in sight. They burned most of the expedition archives, scientific research, interviews with locals, freight and cargo manifests, and even clippings of newspapers and advertisements. So we need to go to Grimhaven Bay, maybe? That might be a good idea. That's kind of cool. There's just a boat hanging up on the wall there. Where's Grimhaven Bay? There it is. Double check our casebook here. Oakmont Chronicle. Interesting. Find the needed newspaper advertisement. Where would that be? Let's take a look. Oh, probably right here, actually. Yep. Right there. Now we know where this is. I don't think we need that anymore. Expedition headquarters, key evidence has been uncovered. Casebook, what else have we got in here? Several men, they burn most of the expedition. Clippings of newspaper. Okay, so it doesn't think we really need to do much there. Interesting. Alright, guys, I think this is where we're actually going to end it for today, though. And in the next episode, we'll go over to the Chronicle and see if we can find what's going on with those newspaper clippings. I appreciate everybody who came out for the video, especially you guys who stuck around to the end. Thank you so very much. You guys are awesome. You guys are the ones helping to grow this channel, and I cannot thank you enough for it. If you guys can do me a favor, make sure you leave a like down below. And if you're new here, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button and ding that little bell. Also, I stream 3 times a week over on Twitch. If you want to check that out, there's a link for that somewhere down below. That'll take you where you gotta go. And until next time, guys, I'll see you later.